We're off by 4.4%, which is a weird market reaction considering that actually the numbers look pretty good in terms of daily active users. I mean, have we just moved too high ahead of Snap?
Yeah, you're right. The expectations were pretty high going into the quarter. Actually, I think they delivered this quarter. It was the guidance that came a little weak. But if you look at the core metrics over here in terms of user numbers, you know, they are ahead this quarter. They're projecting they'll be ahead next quarter as well, which means that, you know, some of the changes that they're doing, especially with the Android app and, you know, the filters and things like that, it's continuing to pay dividends and it's showing results. So that metric is very actually important to think about longevity for this story, because every other metric, it's in their control. The user number, it's harder, and they're nailing that one.
So we see the stock is slipping 6% after hours. Is this just a matter of investors knew that this company is a turnaround story, it has some momentum, they're looking for a little more?
Yes, that's exactly it. So I think if the guidance was also stronger, you would have seen a different reaction. Look, if you look at the expectations for this company, you know, next 3 years, they're expected to more than double their revenue. It's just that, like, the bear scenario over here, or the bears don't really buy that. So that longevity sort of remains a concern and overhang. It's quarters like these where, you know, they come out and deliver on the core metrics consistently is what could instill that confidence, and the valuation will follow. But if you look at these numbers, you know, we think they're fine. It's just the gap between expectations and the guidance, which might reflect some conservatism there.
Jitendra, real quickly here, one of the big criticisms of Snap with regards to the longevity is this idea that anything they do, Facebook can knock it off pretty much overnight, and then it's lights out for Snap. How does Snap defend against that?
Well, they have been against that for the last 2 years, really, and at least the user engagement numbers have shown they're resilient to that. So I think as far as they can keep that core audience engaged and increase more on the original content and the innovation side of things with filters and focus on the ARPU for driving revenues, they can hit those expectations. But if they're going to go straight out after Facebook, you know, try to double their user count, that'll be a very, very hard thing to do for them. So being a content communication platform, keeping the core engagement right, steadily growing and growing the ARPU against that is the best bet to come ahead out of the street expectations.